Noč rende szóra, hogy mit legyetek. Skótszámozásom miatt ez a mai esemény különösen fontos és egyben megható számomra. Jane Haley was an extraordinary woman in extraordinary times. As we have heard, despite advice, warnings and orders, she risked her life in the darkest days of the 20th century to save young Jewish girls in a foreign country, Hungary. It is not only the 120th anniversary of Jane's birth and the 85th anniversary of her arrival in Budapest, but as some of you know, tomorrow is International Religious Freedom Day. And Jane, a Scottish Presbyterian, a Church of Scotland missionary, came to Catholic Hungary and ended up saving Jews. She embodied what International Religious Freedom Day aims to commemorate and celebrate. And in 21st century Europe, there can be no place for anti-Semitism, no place for Islamophobia, no place for religious discrimination or persecution of any kind. I would now like to share with you two important messages. First, one from the Secretary of State for Scotland and the British Government, the Right Honourable David Mundell, MP. When we reflect on one of the darkest times in human history, it is the unimaginable courage of individuals like Jane Haley, a schoolteacher from Dunscore in Dumfriesshire, that provides us with hope and a belief in the compassion of others. Her dedication to her pupils was unwavering. After repeatedly refusing to leave Hungary, she wrote, "If these children need me in days of sunshine, how much more do they need me in days of darkness?" She gave her life to protect others from an evil that we can never allow to resurface. Her words and actions embody a selflessness and sacrifice that we should never forget. I am delighted that this new exhibition will not only remember her extraordinary bravery, but that her story can serve to educate and inspire others. The second message is from the First Minister of Scotland, that is the head of the Government of Scotland based in Edinburgh, the Right Honourable Nicola Sturgeon, MSP. Thank you for your letter regarding the opening of the Jane Haley exhibition at the Budapest Holocaust Memorial Centre. It is important to learn from historical events such as the Holocaust, and Jane Haley's remarkable and brave story is one which we can all learn. Her story and countless others must be remembered and shared in the hope that we will never allow such atrocities to take place again. I'd like to thank the organisers, especially Director Siegler and Mr. Todd Heinemann, for their tremendous dedication and work, without which this exhibition would not be here today. I would also like to thank the Dunscore Heritage Centre and the Church of Scotland for their support and assistance.